Hi, my name is Diederik Brandsma, and I'm a singer-songwriter who goes by the name of Ivy.
Hi everyone, my name is Sasha Bull and I'm internationally touring musician from Ukraine.
We, Sasha and I, will write songs while driving in a van through all these countries and different sceneries and cultures.
Make this bridge between the very Western European country and the very Eastern European country. So, see you on the road.
Even over het project. Wat is het precies?
Nou, eigenlijk is het een samenwerkingsproject tussen, nou ja, een Oekraïense en Friese singer-songwriter. Ja. Ik ben gevlogen naar Kiev. Daar ontmoette ik Sasha en Alona en de rest van de crew. En via steden in Polen en Duitsland, waar we optredens doen, reizen we terug naar Nederland. En on the road hebben we ook een nummer geschreven en dat gaan we opnemen. En ja, van dat alles wordt een documentaire gemaakt. Waarin we ook een soort van de verschillen tussen Oekraïne en Nederland belichten. En nou ja, dat gaat, ja.
Wat een avontuur.
Ja, zeker.
Ja, ik ben eigenlijk wel heel goed en fijn opgegroeid. Mijn ouders wel bovengemiddeld verdienden, zeg maar. Niet mega rijk, maar we hadden het ook zeker niet krap. En ja, dat ging eigenlijk allemaal altijd wel in harmonie.
I was born in Ukraine, but more or less right after I was born, my parents took me to Mongolia, actually, because my father, he's a military, so he was serving there. It was actually that time it was Soviet Union.
I think that I was always onzeker ben geweest. Van jongs af aan al. En dat ik soms ook wel andere dingen leuk vond dan de meeste mensen. Ik vond het vroeger heel cool. Dan zat ik in de speeluren en dan was ik keihard opera aan het zingen. En dat vond ik helemaal te gek. En ik zat helemaal in mijn eigen wereld opera te zingen en te kleuren. En dan kwam de juf uiteindelijk naar me toe van... Ja, Diederik, wil je misschien het wat zachter doen? Want je zingt nou wel heel hard. Heeft iedereen last van? Dat soort dingen begreep ik niet. Waarom sommige dingen, zeg maar, storend waren of waren zoals ze waren.
Once I was on a, like off the yard of my school. It was after the lessons, so I was just like riding bicycles there. And it was two older guys and they said like, yeah, can we ride your bicycle for a while? I said no. They said, but we will take it like with force. I said, you can try. And they tried. And I hit one of them like really bad. I kicked his ass like I've seen it in the movie. I hit him a few times with my head. I crushed his face. He was like covered with blood, crying. And I was like, I showed him. Yeah, it's one of the like strong memories I have.
Sasha.
Nice to meet you.
Fine, fine.
Nice.
Yeah, a little bit long trip, but okay.
It's a cool car.
Thank you very much.
Nice. Good music with the air conditioning.
Okay. The only thing I need is a bar inside.
and the paper that will allow me to drink while I'm driving the car.
Is there a paper for that?
No. I'm just dreaming about it.
Okay.
Bye. But I guess you never drove Lada.
No, they don't have it.
That's why you like it.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm fucking walking faster.
Which, I guess this one is for the thumb, right?
Yes, this one is for the thumb and other. You should put it
like
this.
Oh, okay.
To have it here. Like those two fingers.
Right now, a lot of English bands, they're shooting their videos in Ukraine, in Kyiv especially. Because we're just looking for something fresh and unique, and yeah, but for, I guess for me, I don't like this shit because I was born in this shit and I was like growing like here, and I know from the history what Soviet Union did for my country and for my family also. Like for me, it's like Soviet equals shit.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
And even this Soviet mentality is still harming the Ukrainian society.
And that's what we don't see.
Yeah, I know, yeah. That's why I'm like trying to explain to you. But it's also my vision, and somebody will tell you, yeah, this guy is a liar, and he talks bullshit about life in Ukraine because he don't know nothing.
Yeah.
And he will be right
exactly.
From his point of view.
Yeah. But that's, I think that's the case in every country,
yeah.
Right?
Ja, dit wordt de eerste gig van de tour. Ik vind het mega spannend. Het is veel harde muziek hier. En ik maak niet echt hele harde muziek. Dus ik ben benieuwd hoe het gaat bevallen.
Happy. And though I know that it's a lie, and it's a life we must comply, a pleasant state of mind is something we could aim for.
Ik heb toch wel de hele tijd een beetje bewijsdrang.
Ja.
Als singer-songwriter ook tegenover Sasha. Dat is totaal niet nodig, maar ja, dat is misschien ook wel een beetje een muzikant eigen of zo. Dus het ziet eruit alsof het voor hem echt geen probleem is en dat hij alles gewoon doet. Heel rustig, heel kalm en als mensen het niet leuk vinden, nou fuck it, dan vinden ze het niet leuk. En ik ben daar veel meer van. Oh, ik schreeuw nu wel heel hard in een buitenruimte. Straks wordt iedereen boos en dan moet ik minder hard gaan zingen. En dan wordt het tricky, want dan word ik onzeker. Zekerachtig. En dat merk ik wel. Dat is wel vooral vermoeiend.
Good or bad, we live alone. Oh, oh, oh.
Thank you.
Ja, het ging echt super goed. Ik vond het echt super leuk. Het was echt een heel fijn publiek. Ik ben wel echt teringschor. Nee, maar het was echt super leuk.
Hey man, can I get you autograph?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Oh,
dat
you.
Was wel echt bizar hoor. Dat heb ik überhaupt nog nooit meegemaakt. Dat je de stage afloopt en dat er al mensen staan te wachten met een A4'tje en een pen om je handtekening te zetten. En die willen selfies maken en met je chillen. Dus dat was sowieso wel echt absurd enthousiast. Maar misschien is dat wel hoe dat werkt in Oekraïne.
Spitsmuis. So maybe it's just no, but the soil around is not soft, so. It's not empty. No, it's warm, I guess. But it's like creepy shit.
Yeah.
Some kind of thing is sticking from the ground and moving.
There's a whole world underneath.
Yeah. We're talking about worms.
Yeah.
And Sasha told us that today
the leader of Luhansk People's Republic, where he died. I don't know, like maybe he was killed. Maybe
killed. Yeah.
Yeah, killed. Yeah, for sure.
It was a big
operation.
It shot in the cafe bar.
Oh wow.
Yes.
Shot in a cafe bar.
He came to remember of Yosif Kobzon. It's a Russian singer, Soviet and Russian singer. And in this cafe was a big
explosion.
Oh wow.
Pretty intense.
But it's not sure yet who's done it. Oh.
Yeah, yeah. We don't know. And maybe we will never know.
No. And in the meanwhile, I'm looking at shiny balloons.
If people thinking about war, it's already bad, because in that time they can think about something better. If people thinking help our like military forces to win the war, it's also bad, because on that time they can think about how to build our country, how to make it better. So yes, that's why some people like you can, if you feel this, that some people like look depressed. It's like this somehow, yeah.
We gaan de bus in. We gaan naar Lviv. Ik spreek het nog steeds verkeerd uit, geloof ik. Maar...
I talked to a psychiatrist once and he said, I think all depression and burnout problems will be solved once there is war. But that's like a very easy thing to say in a country where there's no war.
Yeah.
It's too serious song for this silly head.
Тож напишіть у своїх твіттерах, запостіть вже же про те, що риба не є з голови.
It's about motherland and about the title of the song is The Last Nail in the Coffin. So it's like a lot of personal things about my life and my country and the things that happened that time. But you know, as you can see, like it's even more about these days, not about that days.
Het is ook de bedoeling dat we in de bus zouden schrijven. Dat hebben we nog nooit gedaan. En dan met al die mensen eromheen, camera op je bakkers de hele dag. En ik heb wel vaker met mensen geschreven. En soms gaat het supergoed. Sommige mensen die zijn ook gewoon echt van... Ja, dit is vet wat je doet. Het is misschien niet echt wat ik zou doen. En als ik het had geschreven, was ik misschien niet voorgegaan. Maar laten we dit gewoon doen en we zien wel waar we komen.
Maybe we should think of a concept first. How do you normally write your songs?
Sometimes it's just like line that hitting my head like a, you know, like some kind of flashlight. And I have like the whole idea of the song and I'm just taking instruments and like boom, and song is ready in 5 minutes. Definitely, I'm more into storytelling things and like telling about the life of the people around me than about my own feelings and my own life. And Didrik is more like concentrated on what he's feeling like and like the things that are going on inside of him.
Thank you. steeds zachter blijkt die huid van mij. Straks fluister jij weer wel rustig tegen mij. Dan huilen we samen en is morgen weer dichterbij. Ja, dan.
By my side, I'm looking for a sign with the hangman at my door. I'm heading to the north, and then with and
you took it out.
Yeah, I don't know why.
It's a mystery.
Yeah, or somebody stole part of lyrics.
The bitch.
Each one of us will sing about his own way to create something.
The sky is the limit.
Some kind of like hunting for the subject. So each creator, every hunter have like his own way of hunting and his own way of looking for the inspiration, for the ideas of the song.
Het duurde best wel lang voordat we begonnen met schrijven, dus dat zat wel steeds in mijn hoofd van ja, ik hoop maar dat het goed komt, dat we goed kunnen samenschrijven. En toen was het ook steeds meer van, oh, hij maakt wel echt andere muziek dan ik, een beetje cowboy-achtige Americana, stoere muziek, dus een stoere gast met tattoos. En ik niet.
Of course, everyone of us have different way of vision of creative process and stuff, but I think it's cool to be touring musician, like, because life on the road is actually the part of creative process.
Can't stand this traveling no more. And I close my eyes and I see shore. There are all the waves as far as I can see, and I can't spend my life living by the sea.
But I just don't know which thing should be my gun.
Cool. I'm really thinking about traps. I mean, if you are the guy who wants to shoot.
Yeah, the gunslinger. Yeah, and you're like a guy who like plays the traps and waiting for it.
Yeah.
You see? Like, yes. I love this, like the idea and a concept like this.
Yeah. It's a good starting point.
I like that.
Yeah?
Yeah. So we can use this like basic, like let's say this mid.
Yeah.
Ik ben benieuwd hoe het in Leeuwarden wordt. Ik ben ook benieuwd hoe Sasha het in Leeuwarden vindt. Als hij altijd het Oekraïense publiek gewend is, dat weet ik ook niet. Ja. Ik denk dat er toch wel echt wel een verschil tussen zit.
We made it to Leeuwarden. This city smells good. I love the smell of this city.
Did you?
It definitely smells better than our van. I love it. This is actually one of my favorite Dutch things.
Oh,
Want er zijn nog 2 optredens, een radio-optreden, opnames. Dat is best wel veel. Ik heb er wel echt zin in.
You're ready. I was born ready.
Good to have you on the show. This is a show about music. What's gonna the song you're gonna play now?
This actually will be the song about going to the war. It's called "Зі смертю під Вінець". It will be in my native language, in Ukrainian. If I will try to translate it to English, it will be like something "I will marry death", something like this.
Okay.
It's like a farewell song.
Live in Norway.
Де початок, там кінець, кому хрест, кому тюрма, я ж зі смертю під вінець, я ж зі смертю під вінець. Хто сказав, що прийде той, що послужить за зірець? Хтось у омут з головою, я ж зі смертю під вінець, я ж зі смертю під вінець.
My life is like completely okay. I mean, you don't feel like the presence of war. But of course, like, I thinking about it all the time, because like it's happened in my country, so I can't be like the person who just, I can't just shut my eyes and like, you know, close my ears and like pretend that not, everything is okay.
There is something going on.
Yeah, and people dying every day, and that's sad, but like I hope it will end someday. Yeah.
I hope with you.
So, I won't play tonight, and I'm really mad, because when we came to the venue, I got the program of the whole like week of the festival, and I discovered that it's like Russian week. It was supposed to be a program of Slavic week, like the week of Slavic languages. Everyone who like a bit like taking care about what's happening in the world, he's like, know that we are not the friends anymore, and that we are like fighting with them. I really like, okay, I will tell them, and then I will play like as a part of Russian week. No fucking way. No.
It's really ignorant. Yeah, I feel really ashamed.
Sometimes I feel this kind of like, I have this like fire burning in my soul, and I'm like, yeah, I should like really fight for the image of my country. Sometimes I like so like pissed off and tired, like, okay, I'm just by my own lone wolf, and I'm just doing my music and doing what I like, playing for the people, and like you can even write anything you want on a poster. You can even like not mention that doesn't mention that I'm from Ukraine. You can just write Sasha Buda. I don't give a shit. It's all about the music. But then, like, in a better period, I'm thinking, yeah, but, you know, from the other side, this is like my duty and stuff.
Ik kan wel veel van hem leren. Ik zie wel veel dingen die hij heeft gewoon veel meer een fuck you mentaliteit van, dit is gewoon wat ik doe. Ja, dit was misschien een minder goede gig. Dat kan gebeuren. Maar ik maak gewoon mijn muziek. En hij zei ook eigenlijk vanaf het begin van, ja, het kan best zijn dat ik eventjes op een gegeven moment zeg, yo, ik ga er even vandoor, want dan heb ik gewoon mijn moment voor mezelf nodig. En daarna ben ik dan ook weer oké. Okay. Dat zijn wel dingen, het is goed voor mij om te zien dat mensen dat doen. Want dat durf ik soms niet. En dat is denk ik super goed om wel te doen. Gewoon duidelijk zijn.
Sorry, curtains closed.
Wat we tot nu toe gemaakt hebben, ik ben er wel heel blij mee. Dat is echt een coole metafoor.
voor schrijven en inspiratie proberen te pakken. Dus volgens mij gaat het ook wel goed komen met Sascha en mij. We zijn allebei wel duidelijk in de studio. Ik kan me niet voorstellen dat het dan ineens niet meer werkt.
Today is the final step of a project. Today we'll record the result of this trip. The song we wrote in the van. In a sweaty, stinky van. Let's see what will happen.
I know it's time to hunt. I know it's time to hunt. But I just don't know where I can find a gun. I know it's time to go. I know it's time to go. But I'm on this trail for the few days in a row. The forest of my thoughts, covering game that should be caught. Oh, I guess I'm getting way too close. She looked into my eyes, turned into bird and flew away up in the crowns. Restless hunter fed by hunger we want more and more and as the nights grow longer, we're being hunted. The game has only just begun. I know it's time to hunt. I know it's time to hunt. Set up camp tonight. Wrench is tied with a rope. Now all I got is hope, and nothing left to do but wait and pray for the prey to find me. Restless hunter fed by hunger, we want more and more and more as the nights grow. It's only just begun.